Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our General Assembly for February 15, 2021. I hope you have a restful weekend of rest, hopefully, and are ready for the week ahead. This week will be a short week because we will have classes only Monday and Tuesday of this week. Then we move on to midterm break for the students and teachers Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. For the students, it will be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And for our teachers, it will be Wednesday and Friday. So without further ado, you know, as usual, we start with a song just to get us ready. So hold until I hand over to Mr. Jackson, who will lead us in devotion this morning.
Intentional, never failing. I know that all things are working for my good. Yeah, she's intentional, never failing. All things are working
for my good.
She's intentional.
She's intentional.
Hey, and he's never failing. All things are working for my good. He's intentional.
He's
never failing. All things are working. Hey, I know that all things are working for my good. Yes, they are. Yeah, I know that all things are working for my good.
All things are working for my good.
Yeah, all.
All right. He's intentional. Remember, as we go throughout this day, we have to remember whatsoever we're doing unto the glory of God. All right, Mr. Jackson, it's your time. Mr. Jackson is a member of the Social Sciences Department. He's also one of our past students at Fernwood High School, and he will lead us in devotion this morning. Mr. Jackson, over to you.
Saving grace. I know I'm not worthy to see your face. I try hard, but I make mistakes. You're still by my side every step that I take. To every heartache, you get the praise. Like you, I'm a guide, I'm a shield always. Every time me a gaze, and I play hard days. You still show mercy and keep me safe. Lord, I pray, I honor your name. Deliver your mercy whenever I fall. You lift me up, glory to thee, oh God.
All powerful, omnipotent, shine down your glory, your magnificence. When you build the fence, it makes all the difference. Step in on my life and take precedence. Be the captain, the pilot, the teacher. Be the head, be the boss and the leader. Be my guide, my shepherd. And I'm a keeper, beginning and the end, you are the Alpha Omega.
Lord, I pray, I honor your name. Deliver your mercy whenever I fall. You lift me up, glory to thee, oh God.
Even though they plot and scheme and try to stop me,
stop me.
Even though they try them best to take my glory,
glory.
I, even in your hands, my Lord, yeah, yeah. I said, I,
even in your hands, my Lord, yeah, yeah. Lord, I pray, I honor your name.
Good morning, good morning. Glory to thee, O God. Good morning, Mr. Thomas. Good morning, parents, teachers, students. Good morning to those who are joining us on YouTube. Good morning, everyone. You know, it is indeed a pleasure, you know, just to be here, you know, despite what is happening, you know, for another week. You know, just to be given another opportunity, another chance, you know, just to make things right. Now, as we continue to reflect on the theme, resilience, you know, which is one of the tools, you know, we need to have today. Now, let us pray. Almighty God, as we start another week, as we look to you for strength and courage, mighty God, I pray, God, that you will continue to guide us. I pray, God, that you will continue to watch over us, mighty God. Watch over our families and our friends, mighty God. So many things are happening around us, mighty God. But right now, mighty God, I pray the strength, mighty God, of the students, parents, teachers. God, I pray, God, that you will strengthen us and that you will give us the courage, mighty God, to go on, no matter what is happening. And mighty God, as we go throughout this week, mighty God, I pray, God, that you will continue to be with us and guide and direct us. In your precious name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Now, the scripture reading for today will be taken from Romans 8, you know, verses 11. And it reads thus. If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will also give your mortal bodies through his son, who dwells in you. Now, resilience, you know, this is how much you want something and how much you are willing to overcome obstacles to achieve it. I just can't. I don't know how to. This is too hard. You know, I am not enough. You know, these are some of our enemies. These phrases are some of our enemies that, you know, will attack us daily. Now, reflecting on the scripture, Romans 8 verses 11, that spoke about, you know, the Spirit of God. You know, the same Spirit of God who raised Jesus from the dead is the same Spirit that dwells in us. And what does this mean? This means we are equipped with the strength, the resilient spirit to overcome our enemies. I can't. This is too hard. I am not enough. You know, I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but if you feel like, you know, the battle is too hard, you know, it is too stressful, and you feel like you want to give up, don't give up. Give up. No, I won't even say give up, you know, because giving up really is not an option right now. So you feel tired, you feel weary, but guess what? Guess what? There is someone I want you to meet, the Spirit of God. You know, he is a giver of hope, strength, and courage. You know, just try again. I mean, if you try again and you buck your toe this time, dress the wound, put on your band-aid, and try again. If you try again and your slippers pop out, you're going down the hill, and it's slipper and the slippers pop out, just throw away the slippers. You know, we are going on this road barefooted because there is no giving up. Giving up is never an option. So as we approach this week, right, I just want to implore us just to stay strong, be resilient, and remember, giving up is never an option. Now, before I leave today, I'm going to leave you with this song, God Answers Prayers.
If you ever feeling down and like you have nowhere to go, if you feel like an outcast,
until problems overflow. Just remember, there is someone, and all it takes is for you to know is that God is the answer, and God answers prayer. He sees every weakness, every triumph, every mountain and sea, and he sees every teardrop, and he wipes them for me. I get down on my knees, and as they say, help me please, because one thing is for certain, is my God answers prayer. You may be broken and feel bad, but your strength will surely come in the midst of all your heartaches. Your battles are already won. Just remember, in the hard times, don't give up, don't say you're done, because God is the answer, and God answers prayer. He sees every weakness, every triumph, every mountain and sea, and he sees every teardrop, and he wipes them from me. I get down on my knees, and I say, Savior, help me please. Because one thing is for certain, is my God answers prayer.
I get down on my knees and say, Savior, help me please. Because one thing is for certain, is our God answer prayer. Amen.
All right. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Mr. Jackson, for leading us in devotion this morning. One thing we must always remember, that God answers prayers. We must, at times in which there are a lot of things happening around us, but we still have to remember that we are resilient and we are to be determined that we can accomplish anything that we set our mind to, even though the things might be rough at times. But remember, get down on your knees and pray to God, who will lead us through this time. Thank you, Mr. Jackson, for sharing the word with us this morning. All right, let's get ready for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you.
Jamaica, land we love. We all know that our anthem is also a prayer to God, so you must always remember that. In terms of announcements, we'll go for midterm break on Wednesday, Ash Wednesday of this week. For the students, it will be Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. For teachers, it will be Wednesday and Friday. Thursday, we have National Training Day, and we will talk. I will send out more information to the teachers about that. All right, we still have face-to-face classes for 11 FER for Monday and Tuesday of this week. The Student Council Week will start the upcoming Sunday. They will lead us in devotion on Monday and other activities next week to celebrate Student Council Week. Last week, we would have Safer Sex Week, Career Week. And I know all persons by now would have known about the play that was done last year. This morning when I check on the YouTube channel, we were almost close to 1,000 views. So if you haven't watched it as yet, I advise you to go on the Ferncourt High School St. Andrew Maker YouTube channel to watch the play. Last year, our teachers in action, they did very well. I'm getting good reviews about the play. So if you didn't watch it, you need to go on our YouTube channel to watch the play. We also had Careers Week. I know the counselors would have had different sessions with our grades. Sixth form did their mock interview and other activities. So I want to thank the HFLE team, Mr. Whitaker, Ms. Ellis, and the guidance team, Ms. Waite, Spark, Sakina, Mr. Warren, working last week. We had the Region 3 also had their careers exposition. I would have sent the link out to the form teacher to send to you. So I hope you would have joined that session where you learn about different careers. And even the guest speaker is our own. For those who didn't know, Donovan Reed. You might have seen him on TV or hear him on radio singing. So with the hospital or something. He's also a past student. He's a bank manager at NCB. So our past students are out there doing well. By now, if you don't know, our regional director at the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information is now Miss Carleen Segree. He's also a past student of Ferncourt High School. So Ferncourt High School students who are watching us, we have set our mark. The students before have set their mark. You too will also make a difference. So work with us here at Ferncourt High School. Do work with your teachers, work with your parents, and all things are possible. Have a wonderful day, everyone, and you won't see me again for the rest of this week, but you will see me on Monday for General Assembly. Have a good day, everyone.